Live from Allied Video Production Studio in Salem, Oregon, it's Uncorked Live, benefiting Family Building Blocks. On tonight's show, U.S. Bank's Ross Carey, a live auction, and introducing Text to Give. Text FBB to 91999 now. Now, here's your host, Jimmy Clare.
Oh my goodness. Oh, goodness. Hello, hello, internet. Hello, hello, hello. My goodness, that is one attractive audience. Wow, I have never seen so many good-looking people. Thank you all so much for changing out of your daytime sweatpants and into your classier cocktail sweatpants. You know, that really meant a lot to me, so thank you. Welcome to Uncorked Live Stream, I guess. Can you believe it, Rich? It's Uncorked and it's live, but it's not Uncorked Live.
But we are live, Jim.
Oh, okay, that's true.
And we are officially uncorked.
Oh, champagne. Well, okay, I'll take some of that. All right, thank you, Rich. Now, I want to officially welcome everyone to the 13th annual Uncorked Live benefiting Family Building Blocks. Okay. Well, before we get too far into our program this evening, Family Building Blocks wants you to know that we are here for you. We all see what is going on in the world today. And while we may feel the strain on our community, we also are hopeful. We know that so many of you watching tonight have been deeply impacted by this crisis. But the same challenges that hurt us also make us stronger. So let me kick off Uncorked with a toast. First, to our Balthazar sponsor, U.S. Bank. To our Imperial sponsors. To our Magnum sponsors. To our wine sponsors. And a very special thank you to our match sponsor, the Larry and Jeanette Epping Family Foundation, who will match the first $25,000 donated to tonight's special appeal. Because of the support from our sponsors, all funds raised tonight will go directly to keeping children safe and families together. Thank you all for supporting the legacy of Uncorked and for making this evening's program possible. Hooray! Next, to our community, we are stronger together. You are the backbone and the engine that enables Family Building Blocks to quickly adapt to the growing needs of children and families in a time like this. From the bottom of our hearts, we thank you. Cheers. And of course, to all of our friends in the hospitality industry who have supported Uncorked through the years, the restaurants, wineries, breweries, coffee shops, their owners, and all their teammates, we know that you are facing unprecedented circumstances. But know that as soon as this is over, the community is here for you, and we will come and fill your seats and drink your beers. And Rich and I will personally drink all of your rosé. Isn't that right, old friend?
Cheers to that. Rosé all day.
All right. So, our show tonight will look like this. Shortly, we will draw the golden ticket raffle winner. The auction will be open until 7:45 p.m. at the end of tonight's show. So we encourage you to place your bids anytime throughout tonight's broadcast and to keep an eye on your favorite items. Watch the bottom of the screen for prompts on how you can bid on items and give the Family Building Blocks. To participate, we recommend using two devices tonight, one to watch the live stream and the other to use for bidding and giving in the meantime. Between now and then, we will meet some very special guests and hear what Family Building Blocks is doing to help children and families in our community. You can also comment below and say hello and let us know that you're watching. And at any time this evening, you can give a donation to Family Building Blocks during the special appeal on the auction page found in the first comment below. And if texting is more your speed, you can also make a donation at any time of any amount by texting letters FBB to 91999. It is that simple. As we'll learn tonight, every dollar invested in our children will pay exponential dividends in the future. So please, let's open our hearts and our wallets and try to have a little bit of fun. Rich, are you up for that?
I'm all about fun. Let's do it, Jimmy.
All right. So, today, more than ever, Family Building Blocks is even more focused on keeping children safe and families together. and we will remain relentless in advocating for those who continue to need their support. It is Family Building Block's privilege and passion to partner with the most vulnerable families in our community, families with young children who are relying on Family Building Blocks to be their lifeline. You know, when our world is functioning normally, families with whom they partner are facing overwhelming life circumstances. These families live close to the edge, just teetering there, and one unexpected car repair, medical bill, or job loss can push them over that edge. Today, all of us are close to living on that edge, and none of us know what tomorrow might bring. So now is the time to show this community what we are all about. It is time to do something great and to help those with the greatest need. We all know that we are not in a time where we will be fewer families needing less, which means Family Building Blocks is not in a position to do less. It's quite the opposite, in fact. Currently, there is an increased demand for the support their staff so expertly and lovingly provide. Family Building Blocks teachers and home visitors are first responders. They may not wear uniforms or rescue people from burning buildings, but they are so often the first on the scene responding to a family in crisis. And you at home, if in any way you need support, know that Family Building Blocks is here for you. They're here for you today, tomorrow, and always. Speaking of families, Rich, did I tell you what happened the other day?
No, what's that?
Well, I just had my first child.
Wait, you did what?
Okay, all right, that's clever. My beautiful wife, Christine, had our first child, Lincoln James Clare, and he is just cute as a button.
Well, can we meet him?
Can you meet Lincoln?
Yeah. Does everybody out there want to meet Lincoln?
Yeah! Well, okay, folks. Let's check in with my son, Lincoln, who's celebrating Uncorked Live from home. Yep, that's my boy, all right.
Crying in a tux. He really is his daddy's boy.
Yeah, I guess it runs in the family. All right, folks, we've got a great show for you tonight. Ross Carey from U.S. Bank is here. Rich, my champagne's just about gone. Is there any way we can uncork some more fun over there?
One step ahead of you, my friend.
Oh, Pinot Noir, how perfect. Hey, wait, did you drive your Oregon Ducks fire truck over here?
No, unfortunately not today. It does get some good looks through town, though. But the lucky winner of auction item 102 will get to join me in Eugene for a Ducks game with my fire truck at a tailgate.
You know, I actually got to go on that tailgate last year. I had so much fun. You guys had a taco bar and everything else. That was just real top-notch.
Tacos, beer, the whole thing.
All right. You guys heard that right. A U of O-themed fire truck tailgate can be yours. Okay, everyone, stay tuned. And when we come back from the short break, we will chat with our special guest and draw the golden ticket raffle winner. This lucky winner will choose between a one-week stay in beautiful Depot Bay or four nights in a secluded Santiam River cabin. And now, a quick word from our sponsor, BMW of Salem. They are our Imperial sponsor tonight, and they donated the package number 3, a 2-year lease of a BMW X2 Plus driving school in Thermal, California. Have you guys seen this item? It's right down here. Place your bids while you can. Cheers. Hey, welcome back. For those just tuning in, we are hosting the first ever Uncorked Live online auction and live stream benefiting Family Building Blocks. See the prompts on the bottom of the screen for ways to give and how to bid on auction items before they close at 7:45. Or just comment and say hello and let us know that you're watching. Like, for example, I see that we have Steve and Curdy Altman watching. Hey, guys. And the Frerez family is all taken care of. Hey, guys, how are you? Cheers. Carolyn Reed, I see that it's your birthday. Happy birthday. And then, wait a minute. Rich, are you watching?
Of course I'm watching. Have you seen this show's sidekick? He's hilarious.
Okay.
No offense, Jim, but he's really the one who makes the show.
All right. Yeah, you're right, my friend. I guess he is. But now, get out of here. Go home, bid on those packages, and thank you for supporting this broadcast tonight as our announcer. We could not have done it without you.
Well, thank you, Jim, for having me. And thank you all for tuning in tonight to keep children safe and families together. I'll see you all on the auction page.
All right. Bye, Rich. Good luck on your bidding. Let's hear it for the Family Building Blocks board chair, Rich Schultz, everyone. All right. We are honored tonight to welcome our special guest. He and his wife have been involved with Family Building Blocks from the beginning. He is also a dedicated Family Building Blocks board member. With his support, U.S. Bank has been the Bethalser sponsor of Uncorked for 3 years, having a tremendous impact on keeping children safe and families together in Marion and Polk counties. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Ross Carey. Hi, Ross. Hey, how are you?
Jim, how are you?
Oh, I am so well. We're having so much fun tonight. Thank you so much for joining us. This is a real treat, so thank you.
Absolutely, Jim. An honor to be here, although I don't have a tux on. I realized I should have been in the formal attire.
I mean, it is after 6 o'clock, Ross. I mean, come on. So, Ross, I understand that you and Suzanne have been some supported Family Building Blocks since the beginning. What motivated you guys to help keep children safe and families together?
Well, Family Building Blocks was a learning curve for me early on. And I realized that when I heard about the neglect of children, and what was being done or not being done for them, I realized that we needed to do more. And when I discovered by being asked to join the board of Family Building Blocks, they keep families together. They change and break the cycle of abuse for kids and for their family and create a bonding experience with the parent and the child that is lasting for a lifetime.
That's incredible. So why have you remained committed for so long?
Well, as the years have passed, we have become more and more committed because of the impact that we see in the lives of those children and their families. Over and over and over again, as you see on the video, the stories of the lives that are being changed, the children's lives and the future of their lives being changed is remarkable. And the success rate of Family Building Blocks has been amazing. When you have the success rate like Family Building Blocks in the therapeutic classroom experience for kids and the rebonding of the parents to the child, it changes life forever. And there's no other program I've seen like that.
Wow, yeah, you're right. It really is. So you had mentioned that there's a great return on investing in our children from a very young age. Would you be able to dive into that a little bit further?
Well, oftentimes we talk about return on investment in the sense of dollars, which I think is important. And if you correlate dollars to a child that is left without Family Building Blocks and the potential for them, their life to turn out differently, to get in trouble as adolescents, to go into the prison system, we have a return on the investment that we're giving tonight for our kids to put them on the right path of life. But the most material part of return on investment is truly that we change their life, that they have the opportunity like we all believe every child should have. And that is a life that has got great fulfillment, promise, and a very strong future.
I agree. That's awesome. So what do you think about is the most important aspect of Family Building Blocks work at this time?
Well, at this time, it's a challenge. There's so much more anxiety right now. There's more isolation because of COVID-19. We all are feeling that. We all have a different experience. We all handle it differently. And if you think of families that may not have the opportunities that many of us do, the ability to see beyond it, to see past what hopefully will be a rearview mirror at some point, they can't see that. They have more fear, more anxiety. They don't really know what to do. Often economic impacts are much more severe. And so this is a very unique time in their lives, more so than even in ours, because of that anxiety and fear.
Yeah, you can just kind of feel it when you're out there. So how would you encourage others to get involved and help kind of carry on what you've been doing for everyone in our community?
Well, I couldn't encourage people more to be involved with Family Building Blocks. It truly is something that I deeply care about, that Suzanne and I deeply care about. We have been committed for years because of the life-changing aspect. And now more than ever, when people are so much more fearful and children are much more isolated, we need to make sure that we are still reaching out to them, still providing therapeutic classroom experiences, even virtually, that we are, in essence, giving them that lifeline right now so that they can see beyond the moment and see a path for their future. There's nothing more important right now than for us to help with that.
Wow. Well, thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you for spending time with us tonight. Thank you for your sponsorship of FBB over all these years. And thank you to you and Suzanne for being leaders in our community that really show us how we can all be better, both for ourselves and for those of us around us. We really appreciate you. Thank you so much. Now, go have a glass of wine and start bidding on some items. You know, I can't let you off the hook there.
Absolutely not. We'll do it.
All right. Thank you. Thank you. Bye-bye. Thank you so much. Let's hear it for our Bethalser sponsor of Uncorked Live. Okay, well, we just got word that our auction packages are getting very competitive, so be sure to keep an eye on your favorite items. We have about 30 minutes until the auction closes, so please bid, bid, bid. And I see that that BMW is just chasing up the leaderboard there, so keep your eye on that one. Folks, the time has come, the moment we've all been waiting for, to announce the winner of the Golden Ticket Raffle. The chance to choose between a one-night stay, or excuse me, a one-week stay in beautiful Depot Bay, or four nights in a secluded Santiam River cabin goes to, drum roll please, ticket number 20, Bonnie Schroeder. Congratulations, Bonnie. That is fantastic. And the team will be contacting you in a moment to make your selection. We hope that you enjoy your prize. Thank you for participating in this famous Golden Ticket Raffle. All Golden Ticket Raffle purchases make an immediate impact in the lives of our children and families partnering in Family Building Blocks. We'd also like to congratulate Gail Cadlerazzo Doty, the winner of our registration raffle earlier today. And it's also her birthday. We didn't do that on purpose, we promise. But happy birthday to you, Gail. Now remember, folks, you still have auction items that are open until 7:45, so please keep bidding on these exciting packages. You know, lately a lot of people have been asking me, Jim, what has Family Building Blocks been up to while we're all staying at home and staying safe? And the answer is, they've actually been busier than ever. For more on that, let's check in with our very good friend, Uncorked Live's top reporter on the streets, none other than Salem's own Heather Hawkins. Take it away, Heather.
Thanks, Jim. I'm here at Helen's Place, one of Family Building Block's relief nurseries in Salem. We're gonna tour a therapeutic classroom, so come and join me. So welcome to one of Family Building Block's 13 relief nursery classrooms, where normally there are 8 infants and toddlers and children under age 3 enjoying this beautiful space twice a week with their teacher, Nalfa. This space is especially designed for these 8 children to work on social and emotional development, early literacy, bonding with friends and with teachers, and getting ready for preschool. Everything is at their level and accessible to them, like the tables and the furniture, as you can see. And like where we eat our meals, they have breakfast and lunch while they're here, all served family style, where they work on talking with each other, making friends, and sharing a meal. There's lots of different challenging things in the classroom, things to climb through, things to manipulate with your hands. Everything is open and available for them to do to experience new sensory things that might not be in their daily homes. And everything is a little bit challenging, but not too much that they can't attempt it with themselves or with a friend. We have gross motor experiences in the classroom too, like a climber. Most of the children wear just diapers while they're in here, and they're busy crawling or tumbling up this and down the other side. But what we're really working on in the classroom is building up the future of our greatest investment in our community, our children, and giving them a safe and nurturing place to head before preschool. The classrooms are a magical place, the volunteers will tell you this, but the real philosophy and methods of the therapeutic classroom extend far beyond the therapeutic class and begin in the homes with the families. So when something like COVID-19 hits our community, FBB is ready to adjust because we're there with them in their homes to begin with, and we can build from there. So now to show us what that looks like, now that our families need us more than ever, some of our home visitors and teachers will give us an update.
Hi, it's Michelle, the Intake and Resource Coordinator for Family Building Blocks. The last few weeks that I've been talking to families, I've kind of seen a trend with families asking for more specific resources for food, diapers, clothing, household items, things that it's hard to come by. Luckily, our intake team and our home visitors and our teachers have stepped in and are able to provide families. Instead of a monthly call, it's a weekly phone call check-in to say, hey, how are things going this week for you? What are some resources that you are needing? And let me connect you to those resources. Our staff is awesome. And so is obviously the donors and the community for really stepping in during this time to help our families.
The services that we're providing right now for families, I feel, are very important and very essential because now families are having to stay at home and they're not able to go out and get the resources that they typically would on their own. Family Building Blocks leadership did a really great job of making sure that home visitors were safe. And so they instated that we weren't gonna do any more in-person visits.
Yeah.
Video and phone visits have actually been really effective because we've still been able to check in with families and we've been able to stay a constant in the midst of all this chaos and all this change that is constantly happening. We've been able to share activities, we've been able to share parent-child information, development information, health and safety topics, so everything's essentially been able to stay the same, but we've just haven't been able to see them in person. Every time that I check in with my families, the kids will pop on the video and say hi and wave and smile and try to take, of course, the entire attention because they're recognizing my face.
Hi, Mary.
So I definitely feel like it is beneficial both for the parent and for the kiddos as well too, because they're still seeing our faces. With this extra time that we're having without having to travel to families' homes, we're able to add more families onto our caseload that we wouldn't have had the opportunity for before.
Typically, this room is a preschool or toddler room, and they're sadly not here. It's been a really big change for our children and our staff not having them here. Part of our services is having a food pantry. Home visitors typically will bring out a food box per month. Because many of our families are experiencing food disparity, this is food boxes per week. In the last 3 weeks, we've served over 1,075 meals.
We love you, teacher, thank you.
Part of our role is to be able to deliver hope that we're stronger together. And that's the message that we're putting on the boxes as we send them out. That's the hope that we want to give to families. We are here together to partner with them, to serve their family, and to be with them during this difficult time.
Even though people may assume that Family Building Blocks isn't operating, there's actually a lot of action going on. The Family Mental Health Program is identifying whether parents, kids, or siblings are experiencing high stress, high anxiety, might be depressed. right now. I think folks who may have never had a mental health condition are experiencing that stress and are really needing help. So my role is to work with the kid, work with the parent, or work with the family as a whole to decrease the stress and anxiety that parents are having so they can provide that emotional support. Typically, people would come to my office, I would do an assessment, and then we'd create a treatment plan, and I'd provide the therapy either weekly or every other week. So right now, I've had to adapt, and so I'm using what's called telehealth, and it's video conferencing with clients. It allows more access to people, even in the outlying areas like Almsville or Staten or Dallas. Those people might not be able to come into the office. I'm excited the direction Family Building Blocks is going, trying to find other ways to serve families and really benefit the kids and the parents. And when you get to know someone and you build that trust, people can change. It's pretty amazing.
I am hopeful. I'm hopeful that through this experience that we're going to come out stronger.
I'm really looking forward to seeing that first child come into my office, playing, having fun, but also processing some tough, big emotions. I can't wait for that to happen.
I think it's gonna be a really great moment when we can eventually go back into the families' homes. The families and us as home visitors are gonna really appreciate and enjoy just a little bit more when we're able to go back in and meet with families again.
But there is a lot of need out there, and I think we're doing a great job of meeting that need. I'm very glad to be a part of Family Building Blocks.
Wow, that was so inspiring. And in true FBB fashion, responding to new needs as they emerge. Thank you, Michelle, Belinda, Bella, and Ben. And thank you everyone partnering with us to keep children safe and families together no matter what. Back to you, Jim.
Thank you so much, Heather. Holy cow. Wow, that is incredible and awe-inspiring. It really is. Family Building Blocks truly means it when they say they are here for us always and forever. Thank you so much to our top reporter and passionate longtime Family Building Blocks supporter, Heather Hawkins, for giving us a behind-the-scenes look at one of the relief nurseries that provides children a safe, therapeutic atmosphere. And thank you to Family Building Blocks' staff for adjusting so swiftly to meet the growing needs of children and families in our community. Family Building Blocks needs our help now, because our community is our strength, and it is up to us to take care of those that are most vulnerable, the children and families that need our help most during this crisis. But as we learned earlier with Ross, we aren't just donating money today. Every dollar raised tonight yields an $8 return on our investment in prevention. Think about that. In these uneasy times, it is great to know that we can find a way to guarantee a return on investing in our local children and our community's future. So we are now going to enter a time of the evening called the special appeal, sometimes referred to as the paddle raise at an in-person event. This is our opportunity to give directly to support keeping children safe and families together. Every donation made online and through the special appeal section of the auction is 100% tax deductible, with 100% of the proceeds directly supporting children and families who need Family Building Blocks right now and in the future. So first, I'd like to give a huge thank you to our match sponsor, the Larry and Jeanette Epping Family Founding Foundation, who will match up to $25,000 during the special appeal. That's right, $25,000 raised doubles with their generosity. There really just aren't enough ways to thank the Epping family for this, so thank you. As you'll notice on the website, there are several suggested levels of giving with an option for a custom amount. Please give any amount you wish, as many times as you're able, and for the duration of the special appeal. You can also give by texting the letters FBB to 91999 at any time. The special appeal will remain open on the auction page through next Saturday, May 23rd at noon. So please keep children and families in your thoughts through next week and of course beyond. So let's kick things off at $10,000. Our first formal level of giving is item number 9003. $10,000 provides therapeutic classrooms and home visiting services for one child and family for 1 year. Each year, Family Building Blocks partners with over 1,200 children and their families and is the only organization of its kind in our community. Therapeutic classrooms and home visiting services provide a safe, nurturing space to support healthy development and healing from trauma for children ages 6 weeks to 5 years. That 6 weeks really sticks with me because just today, my son Lincoln turned 7 weeks old, and I want to give him the world. And here we have an opportunity to do that for hundreds of children in our community. So please, please give and know that you are helping a child and their parents every step of the way. Our next level of giving is the $5,000 level, item number 9004. Thank you to Sherman Sherman, Johnny and Hoyt, and Mountain West Investment Corporation for kicking off the $5,000 level with the first two gifts. These $5,000 will provide a year's worth of home visits for one family. Home visits are designed to strengthen and bond the attachment between a parent and child. Family Building Blocks home visitors meet families where they are, in their homes, without judgment. They bring age-appropriate information and activities to engage families while also providing referrals and resources for meeting basic needs. Home visitors are loving, dedicated, and trusted allies who help parents identify and accomplish goals leading to self-sufficiency. Please give now and know that your support means a family can stay connected and that they can have a lifeline when they need it. And remember, we're still matching all donations up to $25,000, so anything that you give is worth two times as much right away. So that's very, very exciting. Our next level is $2,500. And before we start, I just got a text that we have another match, folks. Thanks to our friends at Cherry City Metals, gifts of $2,500 or less will be matched up to $20,000. Thank you, Cherry City Metals. And look at that. Dr. David and Jody Rowell just gave a $2,500 gift, which is now $5,000. Thank you. Please give at the $2,500 level now under item number 9005. You can help provide essential playgroups for children and their families. Playgroups are an incredible opportunity to provide a foundation for social emotional learning. Through play, children can learn to bond with their peers and adults and participate in positive, fun routines as they safely explore the world around them. Your $2,500, now $5,000 donation will support the social and emotional development of a child and provide parents important moments to connect with other parents in a healthy and fun environment. Please consider donating $2,500 now and help these gifts double with that match. All right, folks. Our next level of giving is $1,000 under item 9006. A gift of this size ensures that one child has a safe and reliable transportation to the relief nursery. Family Building Blocks provides school bus transportation for children to attend the therapeutic classrooms and get back home safely. Children on the school bus also have an opportunity to bond and share the fun experience with adults who are called bus buddies, which is an incredibly fulfilling volunteer role, probably one of the most fun things you can do. So please, give now, and then maybe tomorrow, consider signing up as a volunteer in the future. And I see, just as I'm saying this, we already have $4,000 bids showing up, which are now $2,000 bids each. So see how this is working, guys? We are raising money and helping our community. Thank you so much. Our next level of giving is $750, item number 9007. A gift at this level supports one of the most important services Family Building Blocks provides, respite care. For $750, you can ensure that one child is cared for in a therapeutic environment while the parents take a much needed time to take care of themselves. And believe me, folks, that is incredibly important. And children actually get a break from their parents, which is probably just as important for the children too. So please consider giving $750 now. And before I move on, I just see we got another $2,500 bid, which is now $5,000. And this is incredible. You guys are so generous. Thank you so, so much. Thank you. All right. Now we have $500. Our next level of giving is item number 9008. With a $500 gift, you can provide nutritious meals for one child for a year. While in the therapeutic classrooms, children receive two fresh nutritious meals each day. In 2019, Family Building Blocks served over 18,000 meals in the classroom. Please consider giving $500 to help feed a child. And you guys are doing that right now. Holy cow, thank you. Our next gift level of gifting is $100, item 9009, and I already see 12 of these up on the board, so thank you. A $100 donation helps provide diapers for a young child. In 2019, Family Building Blocks changed over 26,000 diapers, which is about 8 more than I did this week. Families who partner with Family Building Blocks are often experiencing diaper insecurity. When a child does not have access to diapers and cannot stay clean, dry, and healthy, they cannot attend daycare, which means that their parents can't go to work. When we provide diapers for families in our community, we're also supporting the economic health of our region. We're putting more people to work. This is for everyone, parents and children. Please consider giving $100 as many times as you're able to help provide diapers to families in need. Before I move on, I'm just peeking up at the board and we have another three $1,000 bids. Thank you very much. And two more $500 bids. Thank you so much. You guys are beyond generous. I'm going to move to our $50 level, item number 9010. $50 gifts are vital during this time as they support Family Building Blocks in providing emergency food boxes to children and families through their food pantries. And while they are typically delivered monthly, Family Building Blocks is now providing them weekly as families are experiencing increasing stressors and isolation during this crisis, as we saw in Heather's video. These food boxes also include needed hygiene and cleaning products. I don't know if you've been to the store lately, but these things are impossible to find. And we are helping deliver essential items like toilet paper. So please consider donating $50 to support the growing need for these emergency food boxes. And all right, first American title. Thank you very much for your gift of $1,000, which is now $2,000. Let's keep this going, guys. Thank you so much. Our final level of giving this evening is $25, item number 9011. With $25, you can provide milk for one child. Young children in the therapeutic classrooms rely on milk to support their nutrition during the day. By giving $25, you can ensure that there is more than enough milk to go around. We have four more $100 donors right now as well, and three more $50 donors. So thank you guys. Remember, all of these are being doubled. So this is absolutely fantastic. You guys are too generous. Thank you. Please give a donation at any level tonight. Every gift makes a difference in the lives of children and families. What an incredible opportunity, and thank you all for participating. Children and families partnering with Family Building Blocks are so grateful to have your support. We know we are stronger together today than we were yesterday, and we will continue to grow stronger together. Remember, the special appeal, like the commemorative wine sales, will stay open through next Saturday, May 23rd at noon. So if you're inspired to give again, please visit the auction page and keep Family Building Blocks in the forefront of your minds. You can also text the letters FBB to 91999 to give at any time. Please give as much as you can and as often as you can, and you guys are already good at that now, so please keep it up. Now, we're about to take a quick break, but first, let's check in on the bidding action. It looks like the BMW is the hot ticket of the night. Depot Bay Pacific City? Oh my gosh, yeah, you guys are killing it. Thank you so much. Keep those bids coming, folks. We are just spinning the numbers over here. So, before we go on, I'd like to share a word from our provider of the 2020 commemorative wine and auction packages, number 227, a winery suites day, and 228, a private tasting and tour for eight, Willamette Valley Vineyards. We'll be right back.
Still need your soul.
Welcome back, everyone. For those just tuning in, we are hosting the first ever Uncorked Live online auction and live stream benefiting Family Building Blocks. See the prompts on the bottom of your screen for ways to give a donation or how to bid on auction items before they close at 7:45. Or just comment and say hello and let us know that you're watching. We are counting down the clock here, and we have a few more minutes to place your final bids before this evening ends. So please head over to the auction page and check on your items now. You know, now is a great time to make my mother proud and write some thank you notes. We have several great people that we want to thank who helped to make tonight possible. So, thank you, Nancy Yang, for creating and donating your remarkable artwork, package number 4, Across the Land, as the 2020 commemorative painting. Thank you, John Van Driel, for creating and donating the outstanding painting, package number 5, Spring Pond, Montana. What an incredible opportunity for our bidders. Remember, folks, the auction ends at 7:45, so place your bids on the paintings, the BMW X2, and more. Thank you, Uncorked Committee, for your countless hours of support, creativity, and commitment to continuing the legacy of Uncorked, even though we're online. To my wonderful next-door neighbors, 10-year-old Katsaya and 7-year-old Mila, who generously donated their quarantine homeschool art class time to design and paint this Oregon backdrop for our set. Thank you, girls. Thank you, Allied Video Productions, for producing and hosting our fun and exciting live stream experience this evening, and for producing the beautiful behind-the-scenes videos that we saw earlier. And lastly, thank you, Fisher, Hayes, Joy, and Allen, and Willamette Valley Vineyards, for sponsoring the 2020 Uncorked Commemorative Wine, and for providing me a few bottles. And to Willamette Valley Vineyards, an extra special thank you for introducing me to my beautiful wife. All right. Now remember, you can still register for the auction before it ends at 7:45. You can also text FBB to 91999 to give at any time. Both the special appeal and sales of the delicious commemorative bottle of wine will be open for another week. Sales end on Saturday, May 23rd at noon. Now, someone call Mr. McFeely. These thank you notes are ready to be delivered. And now, a message from our friends at Basil and Board, who are a part of several auction packages. Be sure to bid on them while you can. We are back, and you know there is no party like a party at Basil and Board. And speaking of parties, this party is about to end, guys. We only have 1 minute left in this 13th annual Uncorked Live auction item. This is the last call to bid, so please bid heavy. That BMW X2 year lease, I see that is still being chased. The Spring Pond, Montana, the beautiful artwork from our fantastic artists, the rooftop parties are... Wow, they're just shooting up there in price. Watch out, the trip to Mexico. If you guys don't bid that up a little bit higher, I will real quick. I can't find my phone, but I'm really excited about how everything we've done tonight, the ultimate Oregonian experience, and even the commemorative 5-liter wine, which is right here, which I can't believe I didn't get into myself, but I am a generous person. I'm leaving it for the person that wins the bid. So, are you guys ready? Can I get a countdown here? Let's hear it. 4, 3, 3, 2, 1. That auction is closed, everybody. Congratulations to our winners. Wow. This experience really was one for the books. Thank you all so much for joining us for the first ever virtual Uncorked auction and event. Thank you for tuning into our show this evening. You are now part of Uncorked Legacy, the legacy that has raised over $4 million to keep children safe and families together since 2008. Your support during this auction, the text to give, the special appeal, the wine sales, and they all directly impact children and families with the most urgent needs right here in our town. We are so honored to partner with you, and we hope that you stay safe and healthy. Now remember, the auction might be over, but you can still register to give in the special appeal and purchase bottles of the commemorative wine, unless I drink it all, through next Saturday, May 23rd at noon. Head over to familybuildingblocks.org and check out the events page for the link to register, or keep supporting Family Building Blocks through the auction page. And as always, be sure to text FBB to 91999, that should be the number in your phone by now, to give as much as you can and as often as you can. Thanks all for our show tonight. It has been a real honor to be your host. Thank you again. Lincoln, Daddy loves you and he's heading home. Cheers, everyone, and good night.